hi and welcome back to the 2018 Wftda European Continental Cup live from Telford, UK, brought to you by Birmingham Blitzdames and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. I am the lovely Beatrix, and joining me on this final game is the gorgeous Brom.
Hi.
And the fabulous Sleezer. So we're going to be here talking you through all of the action of this final gold medal game, Brom.
And it's been an incredible weekend of roller derby as well. And we have seen now 10 games. We know who that bronze medal is going to. It's just now who is going to take home the gold.
Yeah, that is Kallio Rolling Rainbow coming up against Dublin in this final game. And we've seen both teams throughout the weekend play some incredibly tough opponents to finally reach this point. So we're going to go through the rosters real quick with you, and then we should be about ready to start. Brom.
So looking at Kallio Rolling Rainbows, we've got 103 Bella Glucusi, 113 L, 19 Katie Schrodinger, 2 Eka Helpo, 234 Edgehog, 27 Jake Karpov, 3 Kuti, 410 Vatuguvima, 4-9 Machu Picchu, 6-0 KO, 7-7-7 Gilbert, 8-7-2 Laura Polkanen, 9-1-1 Ikonen.
And for Dublin roller derby, it's number 12 Flick Labine, 1-2-3 Maria von Slapp, 1-6-9 Brudol E. Locock, 17 Dirty Knees Louise, 23 Green Alcuni, 3 Valdemort, 490 Malibu Stacy, 53 Argy Bargy, 575 Pippa, 74 Stabber, 8 Chancletta, 800 Thea, 83 Dashing Trudy Snow, 90 Lana Payne, and 95 Manaya.
And that is the lineup for Dublin Roller Derby. And you can see there Kallio getting ready. So we're going to see the Kallio all colours playing in
black,
while Dublin are playing in white with blue accents. And Dublin look like they've decided to just put everyone on the track for now. You wouldn't normally see this in roller derby with two jammers from the same team, but they're obviously playing a few mind games slash having a bit of fun going into the final.
Well, as we all know by now, and certainly having seen that last bronze medal game, Brom, roller derby is not just a physical game, but also a mental one.
Massively, yeah.
So lining up on the track to start this first jam for Kallio, it's 777 Gilbert. And for Dublin, that's 800 Thea.
Gilbert is one of the... For most of this weekend, we've seen Gilbert and two other jammers for Kallio on just constant rotation, Gilbert being one of the star jammers for them.
Well, Gilbert looking to try and get through that pack. Taken to the outside in turn one, Brom moves inwards, but door is firmly closed by these Dublin skaters who are using every single legal part of their body available to slow down and stop Gilbert's progress. At the back of the pack, you see Thea as we're going into turn two on the straightaway to turn three. She's knocked inside and going to be recycled right back into that turn.
Yeah, coming up for 50 seconds now with no active lead during the first jam. I can see that a forearms penalty has been given to one of the Kallio blockers, and lead has been awarded to Thea for Dublin.
Gilbert, though, able to get out of that pack, Brom, almost at the same time. So it's neck and neck as they go onto the scoring pass. And Thea from Dublin has no choice but to call that jam. Not enough separation between the two jammers. But Dublin pick up 3 points. Kallio on 0. So interesting setup to start this first half. Coming out straight away for Kallio now, it's number 2, Eika Helpo. And for Dublin, Dashing Trudy Snow. Dashing Trudy Snow, a standout jammer in their last game earlier today. This time knocked outside, recycled back as Eika Helpo pushes forward. All the action happening between pivot and jam line, Brom.
Yeah, so now we're approaching turn one. We're starting to see the pack accordion its way out. Jakarpov stood into that Dublin tight three wall at the back. We're seeing some offense come in, but it's all a little bit too late as Dublin pick up lead.
Well, Dublin now coming round on this scoring pass. Take the inside line, but a quick chip off by KO over dashing Trudy Snow, legally passing by to pick up five further points for Dublin. Star pass to Vatavimna for Kallio.
And just as Vatavimna comes in to on a scoring pass, Dublin shut the jam down and take the 7 points to take their total to 10.
Kallio still with no score, second jam into this game. Brom, the pressure is going to certainly be building on the Kallio All Colours bench.
Yeah, and Kallio with the number one seed coming into this Continental Cup as well, with Dublin the number two seed.
Thank you. 7-7-7, Gilbert with the star, comes up against Greenell Cooney, and Greenell able to pick up the lead for Dublin super quick, as Gilbert is held at the back of this pack. A wall of three from Dublin, constantly moving around, but Gilbert shrugs it off to complete her initial. Meanwhile, Greenell Cooney up at the top there, grabs the points and calls the jam, denies Kallio opportunity to score yet again. 4 points picked up for Dublin, no points for Kallio.
Yeah, this is probably something for Kallio, at least this weekend. They've not been used to being shut out at the start of the game.
Yeah.
But as long as they stay calm and collected on the bench, I'm sure that Kallio at some point are going to show us just a taster of what they've been giving all weekend.
But Dublin certainly showing their dominance in the lead jammer stakes right now, firmly cementing themselves as the team that wants to win. Eikkonen with the star for Kallio, trying to make progress, knocked inside, recycled back, joins the pack once again, looks for the in, passes Dublin's jammer, but finds themselves caught in a fray at the top. And then at the back of the pack, behind the wall of black from Kallio, but breaks free on that outside line. Brom picks up lead jammer 30 seconds into this jam for Dublin.
So you see Kallio's 9-1-1. Eikkonen is still caught right at the back of that Dublin wall, trying to snake between the inside and the outside of the track. But we've seen a successful star pass from Eikkonen to Vatavimna.
Yeah, 5 points on the board for Dublin, and calling off that jam. So 20-point overall score total for Dublin right now. Kallio still holding at zero.
So at the moment we've got an empty penalty box, and we've got the officials are taking a timeout momentarily just to adjust the clock, make sure everything's in sync. And you can see that in the first 6 minutes of the game, quite clean gameplay. In fact, Dublin only picking up one penalty, with three sitting on Kallio's board.
We're going to get right back into the action in just one moment. Quick cleanup on the track, I believe, is happening, Brom. Just making sure there's no sticky liquids out there.
Yeah, our wonderful medics on the track just cleaning up. All of the teams, both of these teams, have already played a game today as well. Earlier on this morning, which determined that they would be in this gold medal game.
So game looks ready to get back into the action. It's Jakarpov coming up against Thea on the jammer line. Jakarpov pushing to the outside line, but Thea actually using that opportunity to edge around their own skaters. She's up front now with this three wall, held at bay by number 19, Katy Schrodinger, for Kallio, joined by 103 Bellicocosi. And in fact, all of Kallio's blockers just forming around Thea from Dublin, not giving any space to the jammer to be able to make any progress from.
Yeah, and it's only when that offense is coming in from Dublin's pivot that some space was found, but just once again tightly reforming around to stop her in the tracks.
Number 74, Stabber, is the pivot for Dublin, and having to play a little bit of double duty, bridging out the backpacks as Dublin's blockers try and contain Yekarpov, but also then jumping in when possible to try and give that offense, as you said, to Thea in this pack. And two, you know, really tightly formed blocking formations around these jammers is going to make that offense really difficult. But Yekarpov, 1:30 nearly into this jam, finally finds a way through to pick up lead for Kallio and their first lead of this half.
Yeah, so now coming in on that scoring pass, the pack only just completing one lap of the track as well, going into the final 30 seconds of the jam. You see Yekarpov is starting to make some progress, knocked out, but the Dublin blocker goes off with her.
And Dublin have actually passed the star because their jammer was just unable to get past the Kallio All Colours blocking contingent. Doesn't work out for them though, as Kallio are able to put 4 points on the board and finally end that dry run. And you can see in the replay, Brom, here, as Yekarpov just dances up that outside line, manages to jump and find the space and speed required to get on through.
So, stepping up to the line, you can see 777 Gilbert in black for Kallio and Dashing Trudy Snow in white for Dublin.
Both these jammers incredibly physical when they're in the pack and able to use their own strength, not always relying on their blockers in the pack. You see Dashing Trudy Snow pushing forward against the front formation from Kallio, edging out but knocked out by turn one.
And we're only just seeing that pack start to stretch out. You know, for the first 30, 40 feet, it was so tightly populated.
Dashing Trudy Snow able to take advantage of that stretch out, Brom, and pick up lead once again for Dublin.
Pack advantage is sitting with Dublin as well, as the jam ends with two of Kallio's blockers sat in the penalty box. So a real strong advantage for Dublin going into the seventh jam.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, those people, those skaters sitting in the penalty box are points that, you know, you're able to pick up really easily because you're not having to pass them. They're not going to be in your way if they're sat in the penalty box. So it does make it slightly easier for whichever team's got the advantage out on track. Dublin picking up 3 points in that last pass takes their score to 23. Kallio holding on 4.
And we can see that the moment that Gilbert started to make some progress through that Dublin wall, but it's just pipped to the post.
Brudol E. Lowcock, the blocker from Dublin there, was absolutely all over Gilbert and just taking away that speed and space. As we said before, this is something that's really key to jammers being able to make their ways out of the pack and score those points. So team timeout is currently happening for Kallio. Now, I feel like they'll be taking a good moment to just have a think about what's not going quite right for them.
Yeah, because for, you know, nearly 10 minutes gone of the first period, this isn't quite the Kallio that we've seen so far.
Definitely.
As if it's Ikonin and Grinley-Coney for Dublin.
Ikonin dancing at the back of the pack, but Cooney is lead jammer for Dublin. Ikonin still battling against the blocking contingent from Dublin, using every skill imaginable, I'm sure, on those toe stops to try and break through, as Green Alconi comes in now on a scoring pass, shut down by L.
And that is taking some real strength and agility right now, and endurance to break through the Dublin walls, which just aren't wanting to let anyone through today.
That very fluid formation that they have just means they keep swallowing back that jammer and just reforming around them. And just, as you say, it becomes tiring for those skaters. Definitely. Okay, so 4 points for Kallio. 5 points picked up by Dublin in that last pass takes them to 28. But 20 minutes left of this first half, and 7-7-7 Gilbert on the line with the star for Kallio comes up against Flick Labine for Dublin. First time out jamming for Flick Labine in this game so far. Gilbert holding on and playing fifth blocker a little bit, and it's called lead, but
gets knocked straight to the inside by Dublin's wall, recycled back. So even though Gilbert's in control of the jam, there's still a good opportunity that, Gilbert has proved me wrong and got leads and got through.
Fantastically timed blocking by 5-7-5. That's Pippa who took down Gilbert. They've now gone to the penalty box for their troubles of a different kind. As Gilbert makes their way through, coming in for another scoring pass, literally pushing against the two-wall formation from Dublin at the front of this pack. But no pack is called, those Dublin blockers have to desist, and Gilbert is through. 5 points on the board for Kallio.
So Flick has removed that helmet cover, was held in hand, and actually gave just a little bit of advantage. So Flick gets through, completes the initial pass, and is just about to come in on the scoring pass.
Gilbert, you can see at the front of this pack on this scoring pass, checks in with the bench to decide what she needs to do. Meanwhile, Flick almost dancing through the pack, but Kallio, all colours blockers, quickly reform around. They don't have a lot of space here to continue with their blocking, bro. No pack is called, and Flick Labine continues on. 4 points picked up for Dublin.
And Gilbert says, I'm having enough. Calling it off. And with that, Gilbert adds 9 more points to Kallio's score, which takes them to 13.
You can see here in this replay, Brom, Gilbert is just pushing against that two wall from Dublin and really having to dig in to keep on moving. At that point, no pack is called, and the Dublin blockers are having to stop their onslaught.
So Yekarpov for Kallio going up against...
That's number 800, Thea for Dublin.
It is. Dublin have just been consistent every single jam so far.
Yes.
They are playing the strong wall.
Yes.
That just doesn't want to move. And then the moment that jam has taken off, like we're just seeing demonstrated perfectly here, instant recycle and then just go in and do it all again.
Now Thea at the front of this pack, I think, picks up a cut track penalty, goes to the box. This is power jam now in favour of Kallio, as Dublin's jammer will sit in that penalty box for a maximum of 30 seconds.
Yeah, and while those 30 seconds are on, only one jammer is on the track and the lead was left open. So Yekarpov picks that up for Kallio.
An opportunity is calling for Kallio to close that differential against them. 12th place, 32. It's 20 points. Yekarpov calls the jam as we see Theo standing in the penalty box for Dublin.
We know then that anyone that's standing in the penalty box only does so with 10 seconds or less remaining, and then they're released at the end of that.
So just checking in here, you see where that cut call was made, just into the turn one past the pivot line, and Thea was chipped out by the Kallio blockers. So lining up alone with the star, it's Gilbert, number 777 for Kallio.
This is the fourth time that Gilbert's been out on track for Kallio this game.
Thea back on track and in play for Dublin though, and looking to make headway here. Lead is open at this point as Thea takes the outside line, but door closed firmly by Kallio blockers, and Gilbert is able to grab lead.
Yeah, Gilbert more or less pushing the entire pack on her own as well, just showing the sheer amount of strength being demonstrated coming in on that scoring pass.
Just showing off them shoulders, Brom. Comes up against 800 Thea once again. We've seen star pass to Argy Bargy from Dublin. And Gilbert calls off the jam. 4 points further picked up for Kallio. Or 3 points, if you like to count.
I do like to count. The team, it matters to the teams.
It does, you're right. 18 for Kallio, 32 for Dublin Brown. We've got 15 minutes 40 left of this first half.
So our wonderful NSO lets us know that we have 5 seconds remaining and the jam is on.
9-1-1. Ikonen for Kallio comes up against Green Alcuni for Dublin. Ikonen gets through the fray, almost unnoticed by Dublin to grab lead. But Green Alcuni hot on her heels, or hot on her wheels, sorry. Ikonen just trying to instruct the pack, checks in with bench, calls off the jam. Dublin do not pick up any points. And the refs have a quick discussion, but in fact, Kallio also not picking up those points.
And so we have a scoreless jam on both sides of the bench.
There you see Kallio's jammer just putting on those burners, saw the space opening up on that inside line. Bella Klokosi with the sweep to the Dublin blockers was able to make that happen for Kallio.
Jacob off and dashing Trudy Snow. You can see, oh, look at the, there was great attention to detail on the outside line to try and make a legal play for lead, but it was a cut track penalty, so it goes for a 30 second sit down and leaves it open for dashing Trudy Snow to pick up, which she does.
And this is a power jam in favour of Dublin, so the first for them this half. Kallio have had one as well, weren't able to take that great an advantage from it. Let's see if Dublin can put any further points on the board. 5 already for dashing Trudy Snow. Kallio's jammer standing in the penalty box. And Trudy comes in once again, bro.
Yeah, in she comes on a one horse open sleigh.
It's too early for Christmas. Let's get Halloween out of the way.
Sorry.
Dashing Trudy Snow hits the wall of Kallio blockers on that straightaway between turns 2 and 3. And in that time, Yekarpov able to get through and complete their initial. But Dashing Trudy Snow calls off the jam. She's picked up 4 points for Dublin, 9 in total in that jam. So 41 plays 18.
In fact, Dashing Trudy Snow has picked up 20 of Dublin's points in total so far now.
So not an insurmountable score difference right now. If you're watching at home for one of the first times and thinking, oh my goodness, how is this going to change? Will Kallio even be in the game? You know, it's not a difficult score.
This is it's a very small margin right now, and a very low scoring game on both sides as well.
Yeah. Gilbert through first, but not lead. That goes to Dublin's jammer, who immediately calls off the jam as Gilbert was heading into the scoring zone.
So why didn't Gilbert pick up lead there? Was that a no pass, no penalty?
It was. It was. I'm sorry, but you can look here and see with your own eyes, Brom. You can see that Gilbert comes in full effect into the three wall from Dublin, and as it pushes out, Gilbert takes the no pass, no penalty.
So Thea for Dublin, Ikonen for Kallio.
Thea and Ikonen almost neck and neck for a moment in the pack there as both try to feel their way through. But Thea leaping over down skaters to try and grab those spaces, Brom. Is Ikonen held at the back of the pack? A strong four wall. As you said before, it's the strong walls of Dublin that are the story of this game so far.
They are their own fortress.
They are.
And we're really not making much progress now in terms of space. Just taking off Fear to the outside. So Kallio recycle Fear back to the start of turn one. Reforming. And now we see some offense going in to try and help Ikonen out. It does create some space between the back and the front of the pack. But we are yet to have lead declared with more than a minute gone in the jam so far.
Yeah, and these packs really stretching out. But just as you say that, Ikonen able to get that lead jammer status. Is Thea still in the mix? I think we've seen a star pass to pivot 169 Brudol E. Locock. But even as they're still trying to feel their way through, Hickenen already coming in for that scoring pass and calling off the jam, putting 5 points on the board for Kallio. Takes a score to 23-1, Dublin at 41.
Yeah, just starting to slowly close that gap. And here we can just see an example of that Dublin fortress, the offense that comes in as well creates, you know, Dublin really weren't ready to receive that offense either, so just went down with it.
I don't think anybody is ready to receive the offense that KO dishes out from Kallio, because literally she's like a wrecking ball coming in, and if you want somebody on offense, that's the person. Right now the person you want to be on your team and jamming is 777 Gilbert. As she picks up lead for Kallio in a matter of seconds of this jam starting, Brom comes straight in, does not scrub off the speed to get on through, even shrugging off a late hit there from the Dublin blockers.
And, I mean, that was the speed at which Gilbert came through the pack. Gilbert doing a bit of one-on-one blocking, switching from jammer to blocker in a matter of milliseconds.
Yeah, Green Alcooney really feeling that hit down from Gilbert. Recovers though to come in and complete their initial scoring pass as Gilbert tries to orchestrate her own team out on track. Calls the jam. But points picked up by Dublin along the way there. I think 7 points for Dublin Brom, 5 points for Kallio, and here you can see where Gilbert just goes in to play that one-on-one. Huge hit, perfectly timed.
There was
right in the sweet spot.
Those hands almost threw up as if to say, sorry.
She's not sorry.
She's not.
31 plays 48 from 8 minutes 44 of this first half left, and it's Ye Karpov coming up against Flick Labine for Dublin.
Yeah, both teams still with timeouts and official reviews that they can use for the period as well. But we're seeing the 69 for Kallio goes to the box. There isn't a 69, so I've misread the number.
It's 60, it's KO off to the box. Well, jammers still testing defences from both teams. Flick Labine drawn back by the Kallio blocking contingent, forced to run the gauntlet once again. Ye Karpov also getting in as fifth blocker a little bit, but Flick Labine able to find lead, and that path is certainly tangled up. Brom. Ye Karpov removes the star as they're still on this initial pass. Dublin blockers with the crowd.
Yeah, and all of a sudden everything kind of slows down quite considerably as Flick gets recycled all the way back. Still yet to complete that scoring pass.
KO certainly doing a job of work there. And KO's 1-to-1 blocking style against opposing jammers is a masterclass, really, in how to scrub the speed from them. You see it here. And actually, penalty for Flick Labine means this is now power jam for Ye Karpov. Only 30 seconds left.
Yep, Flick losing the privileges of being lead in the process. So now it's wide open for Ye Karpov to pick up a few scoring passes potentially for Kallio and close the differential between the two teams.
Argy-bargy had the drawback on Ye Karpov, but Karpov was able to recover and find space on the outside line. Coming in again for another scoring pass, 10 points already on the board for Kallio.
Yeah, Flick just returning to the track right at the end of the jam as well. So didn't get the opportunity to add any more than the 4 points that she already had for Dublin.
In this replay here, you can see KO just trying to sweep the other blockers from Kallio, also supporting that passage of play. Ye Karpov able to just jump the apex, get on through to grab that lead. So 10 points for Kallio, takes them to 41, Dublin at 53, and it's dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin coming up against Gilbert for Kallio. But Gilbert picks up a forearms whilst in the pack, Brom. So this is power jam in favour of Dublin. Second power jam in favour of them in this first half. We've got 6 minutes left of this first half. an opportunity for Dublin now to be able to pull away with their lead.
Yeah, so all of the blockers are on the track. So we saw some attempted defence coming in one-on-one, but now just that three wall of Kallio up the front trying to stop dashing Trudy Snow in her skates. Coming out of turn two, onto the straightaway, one-on-one. Gilbert now back on track.
Brilliant penalty kill by Kallio. The points on the board for Dublin as Gilbert completes their initial. She's now going to try and put some speed on to grab those points, but of course Dublin are going to call the jam. Why wouldn't they call the jam, bro?
The jam ran to its natural conclusion.
Oh, excuse me. I've seen a lot of roller derby this weekend. I just assumed it was called off. I heard whistles. No, you can say that on air. I was right, thank you.
You were right.
5 points picked up by Dublin in that last passage of play takes their score to 58. Kallio on 41. Less than 5 minutes left, and it's 9-1-1 on the jammer line. Ikkonen for Kallio against Green Alcooney for Dublin.
Immediate recycle on Green Alcooney. Ikkonen up the front of the pack, pushing towards the pivot line. Finds some space. But
Ikkonen was able to just grab that lead, Brom. It was literally a matter of millimetres that Ikkonen's hips were through first. So she's a lead jammer, but both of them coming through the pack at the same pace and speed before Dublin's blockers reform enough to capture Ikkonen and keep her at bay.
Yeah, and with the speed of both of those jammers, the pack responded with equal amounts of speed. Just a few moments of franticness going on before things came back together.
So Dublin picks up four there, but Kallio with three. Check out this replay. Look at the, there is no distance between these two jammers as they come.
And the speed, and we're watching this slightly slowed down as well.
What, are we? I thought that was real life speed. 44 plays 62. We've got 3 minutes 34 left of this first half. 800 for Dublin. That is Thea on the line. And Ye Karpov for Kallio.
And Fear is pushing incredibly hard up against that wall of black that is Kallio. But both jammers almost side by side right now. A little bit of defense coming in from Jay Karpov. But Karpov gets through the ability to switch from blocker to jammer in moments.
Yeah, and that mental agility for jammer to go jammer, blocker, jammer, fantastic. But also Jay Karpov just creates speed and strength from seemingly nowhere.
Just defies the laws of science and just draws upon energy from absolutely nowhere. A quick skip over the inside of turn two to get a scoring pass. We've seen a star pass as well from Dublin to Cicletta.
So Yekapov calls off that jam. Picks up 6 points along the way, but Dublin answering with four of their own, from 50 plays, 66. And here you see Ye Karpov comes in, spots that space on the inside line, nearly finds it closed, but just jumps the apex to be able to completely neutralise Dublin's defences. That was the scoring pass we saw there.
So everyone bar one Kallio blocker is on track, who's standing in the penalty box as Gilbert and Miaya go up on the line. Everyone's coming together, and it is Gilbert that picks up lead for Kallio. Gilbert now having jammed 8 times and got lead 4 in the first period.
Gilbert's fast feet, Rom, through this pack here. You see that it's just like constantly tippy-toes. She's not keeping still at all. And that means that from a blocking perspective, really hard to land that hit on somebody that's an absolute moving target.
Yeah, you can see this from Gilbert here as well. Well, Gilbert just taking a knee, but recovers. Some offense coming in as well from 2-3-4.
Edgehog. And Gilbert makes it out. 5 further points on the board for Kallio. Brom takes their score to 60. This is now a 6-point game.
Gilbert probably going in for try and get just a few more points on the board before calling it off. Yep, shutting Dublin out from scoring a single point. But Gilbert adding 3 more to make this a 3-point game, 13-point jam.
Amazing. And check out this speed and strength as Kallio hits that back three wall. What we've seen so far is the solid, strong wall from Dublin that's been impenetrable. You said fortress before, and that was absolutely right. And,
Gilbert coming in like a wrecking ball.
Literally a wrecking ball.
But also knowing where exactly to put that hit at speed and legally,
yes,
is an impressive skill to do in just a matter of moments.
It is. Another impressive skill is grabbing lead jammer in a matter of seconds, which Ikonen has done for Kallio. Dashing through the snow, looking to kind of catch up here as they come in on their scoring pass. But Ikonen, she's already through and picking up points to take us into half time.
So, I mean, look at that. Look at that.
I thought there was a lead change for a second, but no.
Just while the scoreboard was updated, there was a lead change. But
yeah. But
in reality, Kallio is still down, but have all of a sudden started to creep into Dublin's space where they're going to start to feel a bit less comfortable about the lead that they did have. And they still have.
Yeah, well, let's talk about this. Dublin were up by like 30 points at some point in this first half.
Quite early on as well.
Yeah, and they really dominated. There was maybe four or five jams where Kallio were completely shut out of any kind of scoring opportunities. And even then, we were seeing super low 4 points. So the fact that they have managed to claw it back to a 2-point difference is testament not just to the jammers. Jammers, obviously, they're the people out there scoring the points. We know that. But it's the blockers that create those opportunities and make that happen.
And I wonder if we're now going into the second period and that burst of energy that we saw from Kallio in the last 8 to 10 minutes of the first period, if they'll carry that and transfer that into the second period, and we'll see a little bit more of the Kallio that we've become familiar with over the last couple of days.
And if we take a look at the penalties right now, Brom, I think that would be a good story to also tell. So looking at the penalties, nobody's in any kind of serious trouble except for Pippa from Dublin. Now, Pippa, if you remember in that first half with that beautiful smackdown on Kallio Rolling Rainbow's jammer, which changed the trajectory that jammer was going on in terms of being able to pick up lead and change the scoring streak for Dublin at the time. It was beautifully timed, but then Pippa did start to get into some penalty trouble.
Yeah, and so if Pippa picks up one more penalty at the 7 penalty point, she will foul out and will no longer be able to join the team for the rest of the game. So you want to be looking for clean gameplay. And if you're looking at that thinking, what are all those letters? Each of those letters corresponds with one of the penalties for something that they've done that was not legal gameplay. If you want to look those up, if you're thinking what makes a back block, what is a track cut, and some of the other penalties and rules, go to wftda.com/new, where there's a really easy, digestible, downloadable roller derby cheat sheet, which explains kind of some of the basics, but also kind of some of the things that you see people going off to the penalty box with as well. Now,
I do have a correction to make. It's not that they have a 9-jammer rotation. That would be wild.
That'd be impressive.
But they have had 5 star passes. Dublin have had 5 star passes in that first, 4 star passes in that first half.
So if you're just joining us, Kallio on 67, Dublin on 69, here at the 2018 WFTDA European Continental Cup, live from Telford International Centre, and brought to you by the Birmingham Blitzdames and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Bea, maybe you could tell us a little bit more about what the Continental Cup is.
Well, the Continental Cup is a regional tournament for roller derby leagues that are ranked just below teams eligible for the World WFTDA Championships. The European Continental Cup is one of 3 regional competitions, the others being the North America East and North America West versions of this event that took place in August. And as we've said before, the 2018 WFTDA European Continental Cup is hosted in England for the very first time. It's been here this weekend, and they and the Birmingham Blitzdames have been our wonderful hosts all weekend long.
And if you are watching thinking, I could have a go at this, or I'd like to go along to see this for real, or maybe you want to try your hand at officiating, maybe yep. you want to be one of the on-skates referees,
or
one of the non-skating officials, or even, like us, one of the announcers. If you are interested, here in the UK, there are teams from every corner of the country, so you can find out where to get involved by searching for the UK Roller Derby Association. Or for the rest of the world, find out where you can play with your league with more than 400 member leagues at wftda.com/new.
Now, if you've got questions for us, we're also on Twitter, and you can find us using the handle at WFTDALive and the hashtag #talk2WFTDA. You can ask questions during the show, and we'll try to answer some of your questions in the chat throughout the game, broadcast and beyond.
So just 43 seconds to go until the conclusion of Dublin versus Kallio All Colours and the conclusion of the European Continental Cup here in Telford as well.
I mean, it's been a fantastic weekend, and it's worth saying all the teams that have been here have been of such a high standard. The gameplay has been exciting throughout, Brom.
Yes.
Thank you. Thanks.
I was looking for verbalizing. I was looking to the Twitter sphere.
If you'd like to be an announcer.
We're looking for a replacement right now. And so that rolling whistle signifies the start of the second period.
It does indeed. We'll be dancing straight into this jam, Brom. 777, Sarah Gilbert. Sarah Gilbert's last tournament, by the way, with Kallio Rolling Rainbow.
A lot of Derby fans out there are going to be quite upset about that.
Yes.
Sarah Gilbert has been an absolute pleasure to watch over the years.
A stalwart of European yeah. Roller Derby as well, absolutely. But standing on the jam line, representing them once again. Kallio in the black, Dublin in the white, and it's dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin, but Callio's Sarah Gilbert, straight off the mark, straight out of the pack, picks up lead.
Dashing Trudy Snow, meanwhile, has completed the initial, and just coming in on the scoring pass is shut down by Gilbert, who adds three more points to Callio's score, and at yep. that point in the first jam of the second period, we've seen a lead change, but there's still only 1 point in it.
Well, what a way to start out, though. Just to grab that point, make that lead change happen. We said at the beginning of this game, roller derby is not just physical, it's also mental. And does this kind of thing maybe affect the players? Who knows? Yay, Karpov knows, though. Lead jammer for Kallio as Green Alcuni comes up the outside line. Almost half a lap behind Yekarpov.
But if Dublin keep on following out as quickly as Cooney just did, then they're going to hold Kallio to some really low point scoring jams.
Yeah, great way to apply pressure to the opposing team as well, to really have that jammer breathing down your neck. So 2 points picked up by Kallio, takes their score to 72, Dublin at 69. 9-1-1, Ikonen with the start now for Kallio. Coming up against 800, Thea, and the crowds here this weekend, Brom, I do have to mention them because I'm sure you'll be able to hear them on stream. Very vocal, but today, especially with their chants.
Yeah, our Derby fans are awesome. And to everyone at home as well that is eagerly watching the conclusion of this game.
Ikonen pushing forward, trying to eke out and find the lead, which she does. 20 seconds into this jam, Thea removes the star. It's not a pass, it looks like a stash. As Ikonen comes in on a scoring run, tests the defenses of Dublin, escorted outside in turn one. Pushes forward to the inside, but knocked down. Ikonen returns to the track, tries to follow L through the pack, 1-1-3, but gets caught up once again by number 53, Argy Bargy from Dublin, and forced to reset, Brom.
Yeah, meanwhile, Ikonen is just pushing incredibly hard. Fear has removed the helmet cover from her head, is currently holding the star in her hand.
And really stuck in between, down by turn three here, not able to get any purchase for Dublin. Heikkinen decides to call off the jam with encouragement from the bench. 5 points picked up for Kallio along the way there. Dublin held at zero. So we're going to see a role reversal of the first half from, I wonder. Here you see in the replay, Heikkinen coming in and just testing the defences, but finds that space on the inside line, just around Dirty Knees Louise, to grab lead jammer for Kallio.
And so we can see there Sarah Gilbert and Argie Bargy on the jam line. Incredibly quick pace off the line. We can see lead has gone to Gilbert, but out the front as well. Greenhow Cooney gets through, isn't lead, but that's going to force Gilbert to call it off, denying Dublin the points, but also denying themselves of picking anything else up.
Yeah, scoreless jam, but great tactical awareness by Gilbert. Doesn't want to give any points up to Dublin here. You know, we're only 8 point difference in the scoreline, so every opportunity counts, and you bet Dublin are going to try and make sure that they get those points. So Kallio shutting down that jam and shutting off opportunities was great.
So we have the full 80 wheels on the track at the moment as the penalty box is emptied. Jake Harpath and Flick.
Flick making progress, finds himself stuck behind Bella Glucosi, joined by Kutti Schrodinger. Up front, number two, Aika Helpo also in attendance. And L leading that four wall. L drops back now to try and bridge. Ajay Karpov knocked out and recycled right behind Jamline. Brom, look at the way this pack is stretching out here.
All the way between turns one and two, resulting in Flick picking up the lead.
Well, Flick comes up against resistance once again. Kutti Schrodinger with the knockout and recycle as Flick is on her scoring pass. Has to run the gauntlet of Kallio blockers though, Brom. Offence comes in to try and help out in the form of number 90, Lana Payne.
And let's not forget, Jake Karpov is yet to get that initial pass. Gets knocked to the inside. You can see Karpov holding the helmet cover in hand at the moment as well. A common tactic when you don't pick up lead off the line to remove it. It means you're a bit closer to being able to pass the star to your pivot should you need to.
And Dublin closing the gap and then smashing through it here with Flick.
I think that second scoring pass might result in another lead change, making it a one-point game and received with rapturous amounts of noise here in Telford.
Well, you know what? This was the first Dublin score in the second half, you know, and what a way to make that score count.
To remind Kallio who that they're here.
We're going to dance straight back into it. Heikkinen once again with the star for Kallio. And that's number 8, Chancletta, starting off the line for Dublin. Chancletta comes to the front of the pack, held in a two-wall, KO on with that superb one-on-one blocking. Heikkinen takes the outside, moves inside, trying to shrug off the blocking advances from Manyaha. Gets through, picks up lead for Kallio.
Oh, look at that. That was so close to being a wonderful dodge around the outside of Kallio's wall.
A KO once again there, Brom, to pick up the Dublin jammer and just make any kind of progress pretty much impossible. Chancletta does get through on that initial, but Heikkinen already scoring points. Three in total, so another lead change. Four in total, my apologies. So another lead change, 78 plays, 81 in favour of Kallio.
So many lead changes.
But this is so fitting for a gold medal game. These two teams should absolutely be equal in strength and tactics. It's just who's going to be able to dig deep and keep it going consistently.
Yeah, and that's where, like you said, that mental and physical endurance of the length of the game will really come into play as Gilbert and Dashing Trudy Snow become the jammers. And just look at the strength at which Gilbert just moved Dublin out of the way.
It's them shoulders.
It is those shoulders.
Gilbert coming in now on a scoring pass, but about a quarter lap behind is Brudol E. Locock, who's took the star for Dublin in a star pass. Brudol taking the inside, shut down by Bella Glucosi. Helped by Aika Helpo.
Gilbert gets through and picks up the 4 points for Kallio. Brudo Ilocok.
I'm sorry, you go.
I was just going to say, just about to get through on the scoring pass, picks up 4 for Dublin.
And oh my goodness, Gilbert picks up a penalty. Off to sit for 30 seconds. Looks like a low block assessed.
Yes.
Oh, back block assessed. I'm sorry, just checking in with the ref signal there.
And so that means that the lead was lost, but Gilbert now back on track.
So Gilbert is back in play. And scoring points for Kallio. They've got 9 on the board so far. Brudel, Ilocok with 3 for Dublin. We've got just under 30 seconds left and Gilbert takes the outside. Brought pretty much unopposed by those Dublin blockers.
Gilbert does not mess around, just comes in at that speed. Here we go again, the absolute speed at which Gilbert approaches. Going one-on-one with Lana Payne and then breaks through and is just becoming a points machine right now.
Rudolf Ilocok comes up against Katy Schrodinger and he's certainly slowed down in turn 3. As Gilbert brings that jam to an end with a further... Oh, that was a 22-point jam. Just get that in your head. Here you can see Gilbert coming in, takes the fall into the Dublin wall.
And that was the penalty that was assessed.
Yeah.
Low block penalty.
22-point jam. Highest jam score in this game so far. 103 now to Kallio. 85 to Dublin. 20 minutes left.
And we're on a team timeout now, which has been called by Dublin. 60 seconds for them to gather their thoughts.
So that just went a little bit supersonic.
It did, and I think good time probably for Dublin to call a timeout as well. Just to, like you said, they've lost their lead, and mm-hmm. they're just starting, Kallio just starting to break away. And just to collect their thoughts and to turn back to where they were before. As you just saw there, Pippa still on 6 penalties for Dublin. But everyone else at the moment, by and large, is in the relatively safe zone.
Except for Bella Glucosi of Kallio, who's their captain, number 103. She currently sits with 5 penalties, Brom, and has been pulling a lot of double duty out on track in the rotation for Kallio. Very good player at being at the front of that pack and very cognizant of what's going on and where the opposing jammer is. But right now we're back to the action. It's Thea versus Jay Karpov. Thea was Jay Karpov knocked out and recycled. Thea, you can see at the top right-hand corner of your screen, just battling against KO for Kallio, joined by their pivot. That looks like 4-1-0, Wftda. And Kallio's Jay Karpov finds the space on the outside line. And once again, we see this all the time, Jay Karpov puts on those burners at a moment's notice to get through and grab spaces.
And an incredibly slick star pass from Thea to Manana.
Jay Karpov is in that driving seat as lead jammer. As they see Manana coming in, calls off the jam. She picks up 3 points along the way. So 106 plays 85. 19 minutes 24 left of this second half. Going straight back into it, it's Ikonen with the star for Kallio, Green Alcuni. But Ikonen grabs the lead.
Yeah, Ikonen coming round at quite a considerable speed, arriving into the back of turn 1 on the scoring pass. Cooney is caught up at the front, but finds the space to complete initial, so it could be quite a short jam, and Ikonen might choose to shut this down.
Well, Ekinen checking in with the bench, and you're absolutely right, Braum. The call comes out to call off that jam. So points for Kallio, no points for Dublin. 1-1-10 now, plays 85. Still 35 points.
It's still incredibly close. Yeah. I mean, we saw Kallio recover from
exactly.
a similar points differential in the first period. So it's well within the remit with 18 minutes left to go.
18 minutes, that's all we've got left. Gilbert with the star for Kallio. Gilbert striding through.
Wow.
I mean, just beautiful
Gilbert
work.
Made light work of that then.
Gilbert is from the Matrix. That's the only possible logical explanation for the way she's able to stay upright when those hits are landing down on her.
And so Gilbert picks up 2 points for Kallio.
Yeah, Manjeha was unable to make any kind of purchase then from the Dublin side. So as you say, 2 points for Kallio takes them to 1-1-2. Dublin at 85.
And Dublin have only scored twice in this period as well so yeah. far. I think Dublin are probably looking to return to that first 15 minutes when we saw what I call the Dublin fortress, mm-hmm. because they just weren't letting Kallio through.
But I feel like Kallio have really figured out the defensive strategy of Dublin.
And the offence to counter it as
yeah.
well, you know.
Yee Karp off with the star for Kallio. Dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin. Dashing Trudy Snow up front by that pivot line, but being slowly pushed back by blockers from Kallio. Aika Helpo with the drawback alongside Bella Glucosi. Up front, Yee Karp off behind the wall of white. Some interference being run, but Kallio's blockers mainly just focused here on trying to keep Dashing Trudy Snow at bay. That does not continue,
no.
though, as Dashing Trudy Snow picks up lead jammer for Dublin.
Yeah, well received as well. A Dublin lead. Some points are to be had here. But Jay Karpov has got through on the initial pass.
Aika Helpo with the chip out that time. Picked up by L. And Dublin bring that jam to an end. Were they able to pick up points, Brom?
Let's take a look. There's just some confirming happening between the officials, and that 4 points have been added to Dublin's score. So the third time for this period.
You know how I said that both teams were really evenly matched, and so they should be? I still stand by that. It's just that massive 22-point jam that Kallio pulled out of the bag in this half that's really kind of changed things up.
It's given them that boost.
Yeah.
So we can see Ikonen and Thea off the jam line coming into turn one, trying to find some space.
Ikonen is your lead jammer, Brom.
Yeah, and Ikonen coming in for that scoring pass just as Dublin have completed a star pass, and now Chancleta wearing the star for Dublin. It forces the call off and results in only a single point being added to Kallio. So we're happy to have you with us here today on BBC Sport and live on WFTDA.tv. If you like what you're seeing here, we've got more great roller derby coverage coming up from November 9th to the 11th, live from New Orleans in Louisiana. Join us for a free Twitch broadcast on Friday, November 9th at 6 p.m. GMT for an amazing game from international championships between Angel City Derby and Jacksonville Roller Derby. Don't miss a hit. Find out more. WFTDA.com/champs.
Well, don't miss this either. Green Al Cooney with the star for Dublin. Gilbert for Kallio. Neither jam are able to grab lead right now, and we are nearly 30 seconds into this jam as Green Al Cooney takes the inside line, finds the door closed by L. Gilbert sits in the penalty box, Brom. Forearms penalty. So Dublin able to capitalise on this power jam as Green Al Cooney is called lead. Now it's really down to the Kallio blockers to neutralise this power jam against them. What they can't afford is for any of this point differential to be chipped away at. Kutu Schrodinger is certainly on message with that, with the knockout on Green Alcuni and draw back in between turns three and four.
And there's a bit of a Dublin fortress on from the jam line as well. And look at that. Green Alcuni skips over the inside of turn four to get through on that scoring pass. Gilbert still having a hard time at the back of the pack, yet to complete the initial.
Green Alcuni coming up the outside line, but once again, Kutu Schrodinger there to chip off and draw back right behind the jam line. And from this, jam is really going to be testing Kallio's defenses right now.
Yeah, especially as those two scores draw closer together.
Closer. 5 points picked up by Dublin. 97 plays 1-1-3. It was an 8-point jam total.
And then there's that skip over the line as well from Cooney that just, I mean, it was just so simple and smooth, and I definitely couldn't do it.
Don't doubt yourself. Flick Levine for Dublin comes up against Jay Karpov for Kallio. Jay Karpov moves inside, looks for space outside. Flick finds offense in the form of number 53, Arji Bargi, who literally Arji Barges into the Kallio wall up the pivot line. Lives up to a namesake for sure. Kallio wall trying desperately here to reform around Flick from.
Yeah, and we have less than a quarter of the game left, nearly 10 minutes remaining. The no-pack's called, people have made to reform just as Flick picks up that lead. Jay Karpov very close to the front, gets through to complete the initial pass.
That was Voldemort with the last line of defense hit down on Jay Karpov there. But Flick in the driving seat, running this jam, grabs the points and calls it off for Dublin, taking them over the 100 mark, Brom to 101, Kallio on 113.
And again, you know, just short, sharp, low scoring jams, but just if they keep playing like that, chipping away, we're going to see them get ever closer.
12 points difference, where were we earlier? 40 points difference?
40 points difference, we've seen it 1 point.
Yeah. And they've chipped that down to a 12 differential with 11 minutes left. Ikkinen up against Dashing Trudy Snow. Dashing Trudy Snow with beautiful, patient footwork on that inside line, Brom, to grab lead jammer.
Oh, and that was fantastic timing from from teammates as well. So 4 points were picked up by Dublin, 3 points by Kallio.
Yeah.
And we've seen a timeout being called by Kallio as well. It was just the speed at which those points were scored as well, and, you know, impressive.
So Kallio, Dublin came in, Dashing Trudy Snow came in on that initial pass and just literally patiently waited to grab that space on the inside line, but didn't scrub off the speed. It was all about footwork and control. Then comes round, grabs those 4 points for Dublin, but at that point, Kallio's jammer really close by in the pack. Now, did Dublin's blockers get swept to the outside? Was it Kallio's blockers who were able to help form those 3 points?
I think it was Dublin's blockers who got swept to the outside,
yeah.
But.
Yeah. 116 plays 105. Kallio with this team timeout.
But also the, you know, so pack advantage, like we said, is going to sit with Dublin going into the 16th jam of the second period.
And you say obviously because Kallio have two blockers in the penalty box, Edgehog and L. So micro pack out on track for them, Brom.
Edgehog, though, is instantly released from the penalty box onto the track. So a little bit more strength for Kallio to try and stop. And yeah.
But strength means nothing when Ikkinen, picking up a forearms penalty, goes to that penalty box. Power jam in favour of Dublin. Brom, this could be a game changer for Dublin.
Yeah, this 30 seconds could mean so much to them. And look at just the skills. Two 360 turns, gets through, picks up 5 points, but is not lead.
Machu Picchu really tried to slow down Maniha wasn't able to do it this time. Bella Klokozy comes in, also can't slow her down. KO, a ferocious blocker we've seen throughout this tournament. Shows off that one-on-one blocking skill. That does the business as Ekinen back on track and in play for Kallio. Comes in to complete the initial pass. We'll be looking now for points.
Still just under a minute left on the jam. Ekinen has been really slowed down. Meniere having a similar trouble right now. Well, neither pack going anywhere.
No lead jammer, so this jam is going for the full 2 minutes, Brom. Maniha still pushing forward. Ekinen grinding away against that two-wall up front. Stabber in attendance for that, Brom.
You see that Meniere trying to get another couple of turns in there, which works so well to get the first initial pass and the scoring pass as well, but doesn't quite work, pan out this time.
Sometimes you're really able to just shrug off that blocking that's around you, but I think with somebody like Bella Klokozy, you've got to be really careful because they obviously went to KO's school of one-on-one blocking. They don't give you much space at all.
And so as the jam reaches its natural two-minute conclusion, we can see that Dublin picked up 9 points for the jam, Kallio with 5.
Just checking out that hit there for Machubicu, just a last line of defense to try and prevent Maniha picking up lead or picking up points. Wasn't able to do it.
But now it is just a 7-point game with Grinnell Cooney and Gilbert. Gilbert gets through incredibly quickly, but also we have a micro pack on track as Dublin have 2 sat in the penalty box, and as we move into a power jam as well for Gilbert, a chance for Kallio to just stretch out a little bit further in front.
Grinnell Cooney picking up a cut track penalty to earn that trip in the box, Brom. You know, and tables turned once again in terms of the micro pack for Dublin. And against a jammer like Gilbert, that's not what you want out on track.
Absolutely not.
Because it is really opportunity calling. 10 points on the board already for Kallio. Gilbert coming in on a 3rd scoring pass. Dances on the toe stops up the outside line. Late hit though from the blockers of Dublin. Slows down Gilbert.
But only temporarily. Gilbert goes down again, but quickly back to a skate. Dublin have to reform, so Gilbert now having a very high point scoring jam as comes in again.
Well, Grinnell Cooney back on track and in play for Dublin. Ran the gauntlet of blockers, got on through. Kallio's Gilbert with a 19-point jam, second highest score in this game, and I think the first highest score was also from Gilbert with a 22-point jam.
Yeah, Gilbert now has scored 78 of the points for Kallio's total score.
So Kallio 140, Dublin on 114, and Kallio looking for an official review, so we're going to hear from our head ref in just one moment, Brom.
Yep. So this gives the opportunity for the team to query, to try and change, overturn, or get issued a penalty. They only have 1 for the period if they are unsuccessful in seeking their official review.
They lose it.
They lose it, essentially.
If they are successful,
they get to keep it.
Yeah. 6 minutes 31 on the clock.
And the crowd are taking this moment of downtime to be very loud. So you can see head ref chef for the game there is about to tell us what the query is.
Kallio views their official review. They are looking for a low block call to be issued on a white blocker at the end of the last jam at turn 4.
So that was, they were looking for a low block to be issued on turn 4 at the end of the jam on one of the blockers.
I didn't remove my headphones during Schreff's explanation of that. So I'm slightly deaf now.
Shref is very loud.
Not as loud as the crowd here for this gold medal game, Brom. Absolutely beautiful vibes happening in the arena.
Yeah, and it looks like Shref has come to a decision with the crew based on the information. So he will relay that information back to both of the bench coaches and then to us.
The officials witnessing the action did not see any illegal contact, therefore the no call will stand. Kallio do not retain their official review.
So Kallio do not retain their official review and lose it for the period.
And we're going to get right back to that action. 6 minutes 31 left on the clock. Gilbert with the star for Kallio, coming up against dashing Judy Snow once again for Dublin. Kallio's Gilbert strikes out first past pivot line to pick up lead. Dashing Judy Snow knocked back by KO. Recycled but jumps the defences.
And with little run up as well. That was a great distance left.
I think she's been practicing.
I do as well.
Well, Gilbert picks up a penalty. This is power jam in favour of Dublin. Brom. Gilbert's going to be sitting for a forearms penalty. And Dashing Judy Snow has opportunity to close the gap.
Yep, and this is the chance that Dublin could be really looking for. You know, that last 19-point jam from Kallio really started to put some distance between them. But Dashing Judy Snow responding.
They just shrug off that block from the Kallio blocker at the turn one. Like, it ain't no thing. Doing it once again. KO unable to capture.
Gilbert now has returned to track, is up the front of the pack trying to push hard against that Dublin fortress. At the back, you can see Dashing Judy Snow having an equally tough time. 42 seconds left of the jam.
Botovinna and KO at the front of this pack trying to keep Dashing Judy Snow at bay. Does not happen. Points, points, points on the board for Dublin. 15 in total. 129 plays 140 right now as Kallio's Gilbert makes it through. This is a scoring pass for Kallio. 4 points picked up, but Dashing Judy Snow already answering on what could be a mega jam. Four further points for Dublin, Brom.
Dashing Judy Snow is being a powerhouse of points right now as the jam is about to reach its natural conclusion.
Beautiful work by Dublin's blocker there to try and can open the wall from Kallio to help Dashing Judy Snow through. But Dashing Judy Snow calls off the jam with a massive 22 points, so equaling the first highest score of this jam. 136 plays 146. We're now in a 10-point game.
And it has got so close going into the last few minutes.
4 minutes in total, and Violent Bob, the bench coach from Dublin, really riling up the crowd here to say, come on, give us a cheer, support us, as Flick steps out onto track with the star for Dublin. Yay Karpov for Kallio. Yay Karpov at the back of this pack, a three wall to contend with from Dublin. Up front, the three wall from Kallio. KO came in, tried to offer up some offense to Yay Karpov, has to go and support the front braced wall against the Dublin jammer, Brom. And it is 103, Bella Glucosi, who drops back to try and offer up the offense for Karpov.
Yeah, and a really tightly populated pack right now, but some space is given, just enough. You only need a line, but Jay Karpov exposes it, gets through, picks up lead. Yeah. Flick, in the meanwhile, still having a tough time. The successful star pass means that the initial has been got to Dublin as Brudowy Lowcock picks up the star.
But Kallio in the driving seat here, looking to grab points. Oh my goodness, they could have called it off, but they didn't. Brudol picks up points for Dublin. Yay Karpov picks up points for Kallio.
And then now we've got both jammers scoring. Still 10 points between them. They each add 4 to the score. Jay Karpov is still in control of the jam.
And running it, but Brudol coming in. Brom scoring further points. 1-4-4 plays 1-5-4. It's still a 10-point difference here. And
it's a slightly risky strategy from Kallio to start to eat up some of the clock right now when the points differential is only 10.
Well, official timeout called by Dublin, and I have to say, Jay Karpov just managing to eke forward with a further 4 points for Kallio. Sorry, team timeout for Dublin. Edged forward with that further 4 points for Kallio and then called off the jam from the floor. So finally, we're able to get a positive point differential. Here you see it. Jay Karpov comes in. Perhaps a bit worried that they might have pulled a cut track penalty as they went down, decided to call off that jam. 1-5-8 plays 1-4-4, 2 minutes 16 left.
And just on the penalties front at the moment, we can see that KO for Kallio has just got 7 penalties. So it's has just fouled out and will not be. And KO having been such a strong contributor towards Callio's success so far as well. On the other side, we've got Pippa on 6 and then a couple on 5 at the moment, but with only 2 minutes left.
KO, I always feel, is a real disruptor out on track for the positive for Kallio.
And takes risks, which is why I think KO sees the penalties attributed, because KO's out with a lot of track time as well.
Ikonen with the star for Kallio up against Ciancletta. Ikonen with 2 to pass, finds the space, nice and legal, picks up lead. Ciancletta at the back of the pack removes the star. Scooches with the dip and dive in turn 1 to complete their initial. She's going to be coming up now to score points as Ikonen powers through the pack, picks up 4 and calls the jam dead, denies Dublin opportunities.
And so we're seeing a timeout being called by Dublin again.
I mean, a great use of the timeouts for Dublin here. It's what, 18 point difference in the jam. So although we don't have that long left on the clock, 1:45, that's, you know, it's not even a power jam. That's just a really great jam by Dublin.
Yeah.
That could change the
course
of history.
Who
goes home with the gold?
You can see that there is a big amount of support for Dublin, but also there is a lot of love for Kallio as well.
Yeah. Violent Bob giving words of encouragement to his jammer. Sometimes I feel like maybe I'd need Violent Bob just to give me words of encouragement on a Monday morning.
Yeah, I can give you words of encouragement.
Thanks, Bob. How about this word of encouragement? Timeout comes to an end, and we're going to go into what could be the final jams of this game.
Yeah, very short amount of time running on that period clock. 1:41 left.
It's Gilbert with the staff, Kallio, dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin.
And this is a matchup we've seen before as well. Dashing Trudy Snow, one of the strongest jammers for Dublin. Well, Gilbert, one of the strongest jammers for Kallio. They're really going all out as we go into the dying seconds of the game.
Dashing Trudy Snow duking and driving to try and pull apart the defensive work. Support comes in the form of Argy Bargy for Dashing Trudy Snow, but Kallio blockers able to knock Trudy off track and force that recycle. Gilbert not getting anywhere quickly.
But still no lead with nearly 50 seconds gone so far.
I mean, right now Dublin need to not be burning the clock.
Yeah.
And I mean, Kallio quite content too.
Yeah, Kallio would happily sit in this scenario all the way through until the period clock goes out. Or, you know, Gilbert picks up lead for them and can just do that, let it run its course anyway.
Bella Glucosi with the knock inside and recycle on Dashing Trudy Snow as Gilbert comes in on a scoring pass. 2 blockers from Dublin up front. Gilbert just taking her time, gets through once again. Penalties being given to Dublin's blockers, it means they had to desist in their blocking. But Dashing Trudy Snow already also out now on her initial pass.
Gilbert chasing down Dashing Trudy. So Dashing Trudy Snow just doing some magical leg matrix trick to get through and start and pick up some points for Dublin as the period clock expires. 10 seconds left on the jam clock. Dublin has all stood in their bench. They know it's come to an end.
And Gilbert, final jam, final game for Kallio Rolling Rainbows. Calls off that jam.
What
a beautiful game.
Really was.
Just seeing the replay here. That leg matrix, otherwise known as the apex jump, Rom, you might have heard of it.
Yes, sir, leg matrix trick.
Fantastic work. And even seeing the appreciation from Sarah Gilbert on that leg work.
And Kallio are overjoyed. You know, they came back from an entire first period being just behind Dublin.
Yeah, we're really having to claw back to get within 2 points as we got to halftime. And then from halftime, coming out strong, shutting down Dublin in the scoring stakes. So almost a repeat of what Dublin did to them in the first half. And then, of course, that massive 22-point jam to really kick off the winds of change for Kallio by Gilbert, joined then by a 19-point jam later on in that half, really kind of sealed Kallio's win. However, there were times it was in jeopardy.
And there were real risks. And even in that second period, there was a couple of times Dublin just came up closer, and then Kallio would stretch it a bit further away.
Yeah. But jammers of note for Dublin, certainly Dashing Trudy Snow, not just for the amazing leg matrix work that Dashing Trudy Snow showed in that last jam, but also consistently throughout being an absolute thorn in the side of Kallio's blockers and just being a spot-on jammer.
Yeah, 67% lead throughout that game, and that was 9 times on the track. And only actually picking up 1 penalty as well, which is, you know, a fantastic display when you're getting so much track time and you are under threat so much from the opposition.
Yeah, well, you look at Gilbert, 15 times on track, 11 times lead, but 4 trips to the box, you know, but picking up 97 of the points they earned today. Well, that's it. It's a gold medal game. So it should have been as nail-biting for you as it was for us at home.
Absolutely.
Hi, I'm Sven here, trackside with Pippa and Malibu Stacey from Dublin Roller Derby. Fresh from that amazing final game against Kallio. So first thing, what did it mean to get into this final this morning in that tight, tight game?
You know, that meant a very long year's worth of work. You know, we really had specific goals this season and we worked incredibly hard, and we knew that each one of those games, for different reasons, different mental or physical, were going to be really tough. So to get here today was, that was like the biggest success in that way. And then to produce that score, we're really happy. They're an amazing team to play. So, I enjoyed it.
And we played Dock City earlier this season, so it was good to see that what they taught us in that game, we were able to execute training since then. So, thank you.
And you started that game really strong. So I'm imagining, you know, going into that, you had some amazing spirit. And then Kallio obviously brought it back, had a bit of a comeback. So what was the talk like that got you back into it so that you were level going into that half time and then coming out again strong?
Well, actually, like, even from the very beginning, we said that this was a game we were going to play for us, for ourselves, and play exactly how we play at home. And so we actually just, you know, we took that back in. We said we knew that they were going to come back in the second half stronger. They were going to tighten up some stuff. And we sort of said, listen, remember, we're back home. We're playing against each other. Let's keep our basic structures and our form and our skills, like, as strong as we can. And I think that helped kind of tighten it up and kind of close that gap back up again.
And at halftime, we kind of said, this is when the real work begins, because in every single game Kallio played, the second half, they start doubling scores or whatever. Yeah. So we're like, no, this is when the work begins. This is when we need to really double down on what we're executing.
So when you're in, because, I mean, let's face it, you've had some tense games just today. So when you're in the tense games, What's it like on the bench? What are your routines? Do you have Zen bench? Do you have people on your bench who are going to keep everyone calm, or do you run with the excitement?
You know, actually, you know, we're a team who really have had to work hard on trying to keep our emotions just as grounded as possible. We've done a lot of mental training this year as well, and we have incredible pack mums, actually, and this is a newish thing now that we're allowing more people on the bench. So we have an off-skates person dedicated to each pack to really keep us keep the focus there, and they're amazing. So it made a massive difference.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to let you go and celebrate with your team now.
Yeah.
Well done for a great game.
Thank you.
And we'll see you very soon, coming soon at the next tournaments.
Thank you so much.
So I should have Sarah Gilbert coming very soon. So, right. So we're going to get Sarah Gilbert.
Hi.
So, phenomenal game, phenomenal win, tense all the way through. So just give us your thoughts on the way that game went.
Oh, that was a tough one. I mean, Dublin had done their homework, especially on me. I felt it like on the first period I was struggling. They kept me on 0 points for like forever, felt like. So, and we went early on in a penalty trouble with the blockers. So it was tough. I feel that towards the end, it might have been that our experiences in D1 might have helped us to conquer like the penalty trouble and bring us on. So, yeah, that's about it.
So in the first period, Dublin started really strong and had you for like the first 7 or 8 minutes. What was the turning point where you just then took that amazing streak and brought it back and caught Dublin and then took the lead for a while and made it a very close game going into halftime?
Well, our goal was to find a point where we could like dominate. So when we had one good jam, we wanted to make sure that the next one was also gonna be good, so we could kind of get into their head. And I felt we succeeded in that, and that way we're able to start to gather like points more than them, because that's what's winning about.
Indeed. And so talking about winning, what does it mean to you as a team, to you as a player, to win the inaugural European Continental Cup?
Oh my gosh, that's like super. Like, I didn't know we came in as first seed, but in the past we have been playing like in the lower seats, and we have kind of been always the underdog, so coming in here as the first seed was weird.
A little strange.
Yes, really strange. So it was kind of weird to have the team as a mindset to build like, okay, we are now expected to win. so we worked on that a lot. So but as a team, it's amazing to be here. Thank you so much for organizing this, the Wftda and the hosting league. It was epic. So thank you.
And so finally, just what's your advice to the aspiring skaters, the young skaters, the people who are watching right now on the BBC who have never even thought about playing roller derby yet? What's your advice to them to get them where you are right now?
Just work hard. Like, with willpower and with hard work, you can achieve anything.
You can do whatever you want.
Excellent.
Just do it.